Hello all you hardcore boxing fans out there, how are you doing? It's Big Porky here. With the Helmets of the Month video. Got a list here. Bum bum bum. We're all in professional today, aren't we? We've got 15 names here. These are as voted by you boxing fans. You will have seen the tweet that went out the other day. You can vote for the Helmet of the Month by tweeting and emailing. So we use the Twitter for uploading, and every now and then I'll interact with people, but not a lot, because in my opinion there's too many double agents on Twitter. People that are acting out the fantasies, pretending to be other people and having conversations with themselves. You know who you are, get help. That's all I'm going to say, get help. The Helmets of the Month, well, there's some movement, should we say. It's usually a base of about 25, 28 people. And in 15th place, in at number 15, should I say, Michael Hennessy, boxing promoter. How you doing, Mick? People have only voted for him because they want to cause problems for me putting him in this. That's why there's a little band of brothers of you out there sending these votes in. Obviously, you know, I'm gonna do it by the book, because I don't own all the channel, do I? I only own half, so we play good cop, bad cop, don't we, me and NJ? But Mick Hennessy, number 15. I don't know why Mick's been involved, because Mick don't get involved in social media, and he's actually half alright, Mick. You know, he's not one of them guys that you're going to go out for a drink with. He likes to go out for a bite to eat and that, and you know, he don't get involved in all that after show party stuff, and he's just straight up and down boxing, isn't he, like Frank Warren, Mick. He's not, you know, into all that other stuff, and you know, he's not everybody's best mate like Eddie, and he's my best mate. This is my new best friend. This is my new best friend, Lee Purdy. This is my new best friend, Kell Brook. This is my new best friend, Dave Allen. This is my new best friend, Anthony Joshua. And that's how he is, isn't he? So Carl Froch were his best mate, wasn't he, at one point, and Tony Bellew. Everybody's Eddie Earn's best mate if you're earning him. If you're not used to him, he has a button on his phone and he just goes boom, and you ring him and you can see his picture on WhatsApp, but you can't get through to him. So, but when he needs you, he will get in touch and you will go, hello, yes please, yes please, Eddie. Bit like Bob off Blockbusters, Bob Allnest. Now, Mick Hennessy, number 15. Sorry, Mick. This is why I want people to put your votes in. Say, like I said in the video the other day, it's Fred from Doncaster, and I want to vote for Adam Smith because he looks like Rumpelstiltskin. You know, things like that. And you can put that on Twitter, or you can do it in an email. I prefer it in an email because they're easy for me to add up, and rather than going up and down on Twitter. Because if I go on Twitter to add them up, I've got to get the password to do it first, and then I'll end up reading stuff on Twitter and I'll get sidetracked and I'll not be able to do it. But channel's going in right direction at the moment, so I'd prefer it by email. But if you have to send them by Twitter and you don't want to do it by email, send it to the email. It's at cornerporky, C-O-R-N-E-R, porky, P-O-R-K-Y. The email, porkycorner@mail.com. gmail.com. That's it. So, number 14. Mac the Knife, MTK. Mac the Knife. That's Mac the Knife. That's a weird nickname, that, isn't it, for a boxer, calling yourself a knife. Very strange, but Matthew Macklin's number 14. I don't know why. I quite like Matthew Macklin. I met him at Froch Youssef Mack fight. I had a chat with him there. They actually took my hoodie off me. Me and my friend Gibbo went to that fight. They took my hoodie off me because you're not allowed hoodies at the Nottingham Arena. They went back. They said, oh, it's okay, we'll give you it at the end. They took it off me and they gave me a t-shirt. At the time, I wore 28 stone. They gave me a t-shirt that fit Mr. Bean. So it come to there and they said, I've got belly hanging out and blah-de-blah. But anyway. Matthew Macklin, you've been voted, so what can I do? You've probably said something that's annoyed somebody in an interview. I know you are a bit of a company man with Sky. I know you and Mr. Bean are like that. And when you associate yourself with shit, it leaves stains, doesn't it? Now, Mr. Bean is shit. And he's obviously left a stain on you, Matthew. I think you're cooler than knocking about with Mr. Bean. But who knows? Maybe you've got plans to get rid of Mr. Bean and slot yourself in at Sky when he goes to DAZN. I don't know. But you voted number 14, Matthew, and I do apologise, but Matthew Macklin, you are number 14 helmet of the month for May. Number 13, Ben Davidson. I don't know why people have voted for him. I think it's probably all the Matchroom FC lot that have sent it in regarding Ben Davidson, but he does do a lot of interviews, doesn't he? He's getting a lot of press. And his best win's that guy overnight, innit, really? I mean, who is his best win? You know, he's got a bit of weight off Tyson, hasn't he? £138. But Tyson's done that all his career, hasn't he? So, Ben Davidson, you are number 13 at Helmet of the Month for May. Sorry, Ben, but all the best for the future, though. Number 12. The Slave Master himself. Hey, the Slave Master, Barry Hearn, the Godfather, aka Bazza, number 12 helmet of the month. Say no more, really, with what Bazza's been coming out with. Every time they wheel him out in his Shackleton's high seat chair, he says something controversial because he's a promoter, isn't he? He's an old school promoter, though, and he basically needs putting in a home, doesn't he? But I've got a soft spot for Bazza. If I were going to have a beer with somebody, I'd prefer it to be with Bazza, because he can neck a few, rather than Eddie, because Eddie would just get up my nose, really, because he's not self-made, is he? He's had it get him. Now, I know he likes to say he's the silver spoon boy, but he turned it gold, but no. Your dad give you a leg up, Eddie, but you can only deal with and you've been dealt with, can't you? So, but Barry Earn, you are voted number 12, pound for pound, helmet of the month for May on Porky's Corner. Keep on trucking, Baz, the Godfather. Number 11, and God, he's not in top 10. NJ, he's not in top 10. Nick, I can't believe he's not in top 10. You need to, I demand a recount. Malcolm fucking X, aka Spencer X, Spencer Fearon, from GimpvilleIsland.com. Spencer Fearon, you are number 11, Helmet of the Month, pound for pound on Porky's Corner. How are you not in the top 10, Spencer Fearon? You have slipped, Spencer Fearon slipped out of the top 10. Oh my God. Oh my God, unbelievable. Everybody must have been watching AJ's interviews this week and Andy Ruiz's lot and blah-de-blah and Tyson Fury putting stuff out, you know, because it's fight week for Joshua and trying to get a bit of PR, and Spencer Fearon slipping. Spencer Fearon slipping out of the top 10 for the pound for pound helmet of the month for May. on Porky's Corner. Oh my God. In at number 10, but down at number 10. The one and only. Born in Calcutta, India. Dave Caldwell. Otherwise known as Matchroom FC's best trainer in the world. Ring Magazine nominated, is he? Oh my God. Fowler been beat. Gill been beat. Bellew been knocked out. Both of McDonald's knocked out. And the man just keeps doing interview after interview after interview. Whenever I go, I see Dave Caldwell on internet. Every time I put a boxing channel on, I've got Dave Caldwell in front of me. Coming out with a Dave Caldwell analogy, or whatever they call it. We call it Davelish. You know, there's English and there's Davelish. You know, like slip your right hand and double your jab and all that, and move your feet and blah-de-blah, and twos and threes, threes and fours. Davelish. There's English and there's Davelish. So Dave Caldwell, are we well, Dave? I'm making you relevant, but you are number 10 element of the month for me on Porky's Corner. Good. Well done, Dave. Number 9. Well, he's there, isn't he? He seems to be popular at the moment. Gareth A. Davis. The guy with the long hair, and he's doing these fancy scissor kicks, and he's walking around basically thinking that he's an OG, and he's not an OG. He's never been an OG, Gareth A. Davis, but Gareth A. Davis, you are a helmet for me on Porky's Corner. And you need to start answering your tweets, Gareth, because many a time I've sent you a tweet regarding certain questions that I want you to ask Eddie Hearn, and you do not reply. But yet when people send you a tweet saying, who do you think's a masterful boxer, you come back with Tyson Fury, or who do you think's a promoter's dream, you come back with Anthony Joshua. You're all for them, but when anybody asks you a question about Stubbub or Eddie Hearn, you don't answer Gareth A. Davis. You're getting up people's noses. So Gareth A. Davis, jog on at number 9. In at number 8, David Costcutter Hay. Now, David A, what can we say about David A? He pulled out of two fights with Tyson Fury. Well, let's back up a little bit, right? We all know that he fought Valuev, don't we? In a circus act fight. And then he fought an Adam Booth, were known as this technician guy, because he was stood in a pair of high heels, one on pads and all that. Now, he just did that to make his son look good, didn't he, the Dark Lord Adam Booth. But nobody's saying he ain't a good trainer, though. But David A, this is how I look at it. He fought Ruiz, didn't he? After Valuev, for that pay-per-view. Then he fought... What did he fight then? He fought Chisora at West Ham, didn't he? He went missing for years, and he came back against these two soft touchers on Dave Channel. £1 million a fight. But let's just back up a little bit. Did he pull out of two fights with Tyson Fury? And before that, he fought Vladimir Klitschko, and he stood on a table at the presser, and they called it hashtag toegate. He said he couldn't fight because of his little toe. So his little toe's hurting him. So that pay-per-view was a disaster. Is that after Valuev and John Ruiz? So we've had Enzo Macaronelli, he knocked him out on pay-per-view Satana. Valuev and Ruiz, were they pay-per-views? I think they were. But you'd have to check that. What other one? Vladimir, Togate. What are all that about? Togate. So we've had Togate. Them others might not have been pay-per-view, but Togate were pay-per-view, wasn't it? What did we have after Togate? We had the Fury pullouts. Then we had the Arnold Di Giorgio and that Di Mori farces, £1 million fight. Then after that, who did we have then? Do we have David A? Do we have David A? Did we have anybody in between? Sorry, did David A, sorry, fought Bellew, didn't he, twice? Bellew, what's all that about? Tony Bellew, he fought him twice. Held together by Sellotape. So, as far as I know, we've had Enzo Macaronelli, a two-round demolition. Togate. We've had two Tyson Fury pullouts. We've had the Dave Channel ones, they were pay-per-view. And we've had the two Bellews. So that's six disaster pay-per-views. Two that didn't happen, that cost Sky a lot of money. It cost Tyson Fury a lot of money. We've had the two Bellew farces where he's held together by Sellotape. We've had the Vladimir one. I'm sure Ruiz and Valuev were pay-per-view. So, David A, you are a helmet for number 8 for May. Alright. Number 7. Down at number 7. Eduardo! Eddie Hearn's down at number 7. After the bullshit that he's been coming out with this week regarding Andy Ruiz. He's fast. He's got fast hands. Don't let his body put you off. Oh, no. Don't let a body put...
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home.
Put you off just because he's fat, he can fight. Well, Butterbean were fat, and you won't put Joshua in with Butterbean, would you? But Eddie Hearn, you could sell water to somebody living in Iceland. You could sell sand to Arabs. Eddie Hearn, you are an helmet for number 7. Eddie and his old man are in. Number 5. No, number 6. Tyson Fury. Well, I think Tyson's been added because basically he's ranting off about this and that in it because it's fight week for Joshua and he likes to get his Senate news and that. But Tyson, a lot of people are complaining, he's fighting Tom Schwartz. Now, Tyson Fury, in the last 4 years, beat who? Beat Vladimir, hasn't he, in the last 4 years, that's it. That's his best win. Since he's come back from 2015, who's his best win? Well, on paper, it's Pianetta. Tyson's best win on paper in last since Vladimir is Pianetta, the Italian sausage. So, Tyson, I'm sorry, mate, but the fans have voted you as a helmet of the month. So, Tyson, number 6. Number 5. He's there again. You've guessed it. Mr. Bean! Mr. Bean, number 5. You are always there, pound for pound. You're always in the mix. Tough, rugged, durable, class the operator, class. Yeah, Mr. Bean went to school with Boris Johnson, George Osborne and David Cameron at Eton. Didn't you, Adam Smith? You went to school at Eton. You've got about as much street cred. You've got about as much street cred as Eddie Hearn. Because Eddie's got no street cred, has he? And it really, really bothers him because he'd love to have a bit of street cred, but he's never been locked up, has he, Eddie? You know, he's...
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home.
He's never... Look. People are going to say Eddie Hearn's one at boys, isn't he? We've all been there when Eddie Hearn cracks a joke at a press conference when cameras are not there. And everybody laughs, don't they? I've been there, I've been at the butt of a couple of Eddie's jokes at a press conference. Everybody laughed and I'm like, I didn't find that funny. But everybody's gonna laugh, aren't they? Because Eddie Hearn, he's got the keys to the Magic Kingdom, hasn't he? He's got the keys to the Magic Kingdom, Eddie Hearn, and whenever he's got that, well, people are gonna laugh, aren't they? Yes, please, Eddie. Yes, please. Yeah, we're thinking about putting one of your fighters on show. This is how much it's gonna be. What do you think? Yes, please, Eddie. Yes, please, Bob. Like Blockbusters, isn't it? Yes, please, Bob. But yeah, Eddie. Adam Smith. Sorry, you're in the mix. But Mr. Bean. Let's have a look. Frank Smith, number 4. Frank Smith with the spots. Frank Smith with the spots. Why would Frank Smith be in the votes this time? Why would he be in the votes, Frank Smith? Why? Why? Because he's doing interview after interview after interview, boxing, social, IFL. Why? Why? You're not a promoter, Frank. You're not a promoter. You make the tea for Eddie. Why are you doing all these interviews? Get over yourself. You've been voted it, Frank. Get some oxygen on them spots. You need it. Number 3, he's always there, isn't he? He's always in the mix. Johnny Nelson. Johnny, massive elbows. He's got massive elbows. I think somebody said he's got massive elbows. Massive summer. Is it feet? Johnny Nelson is number 3, pound for pound. He's always there or thereabouts. Sky have been wheeling about now gradually. But it looks to me like he isn't flavour of the month, but I don't want to hear him coming out with this again, that it's not about bodies. And Andy Ruiz has got fast hands. They're talking about him like he's a prime Cassius Clay. Fucking Jesus, it's Andy Ruiz. Could knock skin off a rice pudding. I don't want to hear another person say to me, he beat Parker. Because the same people were saying Parker beat Ruiz before he fought Joshua. I don't want to see it. I don't want to see it. Number 2. The disappearing man himself. Tony, the disappearing man, Bellew. I want to disappear, Cougs. De Gale's dressing room before he fought Eubank. Sat ringside doing 30 minute interviews on IFL. Soccer AM. Sky Sports pundit work. Tony Bellew, I give you the main man. The disappearing man, Tony Bellew. Tony, just leave us alone, will you, mate? Either come back or go back to working in that car insurance place. But leave us alone, Tony. We can't cope with it. Only joking, I can't cope without Tony, to be honest. Where would we be without Tony Bellew? Ice, ice, baby. The number 1 helmet of the month for May. I can't believe who it is, Nick. The one, the only, Philip Sims, aka The Stig. The Stig is number 1. 44 votes! Jesus! The Stig fan club have voted for him, or should I say, those that don't are not keen on him, but I don't know how he's going to take it, but the Stig is number 1, knocking off Bellew. So let's have a rundown then, shall we? Mick Hennessy, number 15, Macklin, 14, Ben Davison, 13, Barry Hearn, 12. Spencer Fearing 11, Dave Caldwell 10, Gareth A. Davis 9, David A. 8, Eddie Hearn 7, Tyson Fury 6, Adam Smith 5, Frank Smith with the spots 4, Johnny Nelson 3, Tony Bellew number 2, and yet I'm not going blind. The number 1 helmet of the month for May 2019. Pound for pound is Philip Sims. aka Stig the Taxi Driver from London! Oh my god! Peace out, keep on trucking! Off to the gym now.
There is somebody who feels it's okay to take messages from that group and disseminate them to the public. It's a private message group. Whoever's doing that is a grass. That's what they are. I've